That's what this is all about, celebration, all right? Jeff?
Well, my name is Jeff Boyd Jr., birthed by Jeff Sr. and Lamont Bowman. They were telling me to create a little speech for my mom or something like that, and I was just thinking. I honestly did not know what to say, because there's too many things that I could say, but not a lot of time. So this woman is basically my superhero. I honestly, if there was anybody in this world that I gave my life to, that's my mom. I love this woman more than anything. This woman is the woman who showed me how to treat females and treat other people. She's always came when I needed her. When I definitely needed something, she had it with my father. And
most of you guys probably knew me as long as you guys knew my mom, you weren't here. So you guys see me being raised by my mother, and I think that she did a pretty good job. She does not want nothing bad to happen to me. She doesn't want me to follow in no negative footsteps. She just wants me to obviously be like her. She has had so many milestones from Kansas City all the way down to Baltimore, Maryland by herself. Her mom, her dad was in Kansas, but she came down here. She went to school, she finished school, she started her family here in Baltimore, Maryland by herself. And I think that's very, very strong, because I have yet to leave the nest. So I can say that is one powerful woman. And I just want to say, I love you, mom.
I can remember the moment I first met Mona, and I'm not going to go through that story because we don't seem to agree on what exactly happened. So if you want the truth, you see me on the corner somewhere on the side, and I'll give you the truth. But okay, all right. I got a witness. All right. But from that point on, Ramona has made me happy repeatedly. Again, when I first met her, I thought that I was one of the luckiest guys on earth. Later on, as you can see, raising two beautiful kids. Beautiful, again, they're like 51% me. So. But again, she's been I see her as a true blessing. Those who know Ramona know that knowing her, you will have a friend for life. Someone who is so loyal and dedicated to the people that she know, and always, always willing to give to. And if she receives something back, so what? That's fine. But it's never the intent. So one of the things I most admired about her is her integrity. She's a very honest woman, and again, just very loyal. So Ramona, I love you. Thanks for everything. And I look, you know, we'll do this again in 50 more years. You know, so that's the way I see it.
I can't go on unless I take an opportunity to address some people and say thank you, because I don't know when I'll have this opportunity to really do it in front of so many people. I have to tell you that I am so overwhelmed and excited and happy that all of you guys came out today. I didn't really know what to expect, so I thank you. I also want to thank God for giving me an opportunity to be here for 50 years. And I want to thank my mom. My mom flew in from Kansas City, and of course without her, there would be no me. And although my dad is not here, my dad will turn 81 years this year in July, but he's not one who wants to really get on planes anymore. But he's an 81-year-old, still in his right, stubborn mind. But he sent his cards and his jokes still go along with them. We won't talk about that. I want to thank my brother, one of my three brothers, who also flew in from Kansas City, Edmund. Thank you, I appreciate you, and just for you taking the time out and coming out here to celebrate with me, I appreciate that. And then I have an aunt, and she is younger than me, so don't think that she's like over 50 and she looks fabulous, but but this is my aunt, Zenobia, who's from Kansas City also. Okay. Of course, my children, Dominique and Jeff, and because I'm not in a mental institution or locked up, you know, that means that they haven't really been that bad of kids. So I thank you both, and I appreciate you. I want to thank my extended family, my in-laws, my mother-in-law, Maxine, my aunt, who's Jeff's aunt, and aunt by marriage. We call her baby sis. I want to thank my sister-in-law, Cheryl and Sharon, my brother-in-laws, Sean and Nick, my cousins, Stefan, Kevin, Kirsten. I love you guys. I know we don't always get together as much as we should, but I'm always thinking about you guys, and if you guys didn't have Jeff, then I wouldn't have one of the greatest men that I know, so I appreciate you, and I appreciate you coming out. Let's see. Corey, thank you. I went to Corey as a friend for help. This is what she does. Huh? Oh. That anybody who knows Corey, you know, you just can't ask one question, you know, how do you do this? Because then she just takes it and then she runs with it. But I so appreciate you not just helping with this party, but I appreciate the fact that you've been a good friend to me and my line sister, so thank you. And I'm gonna go here quickly here, sorry. Also have to say to my Morgan family, the Morgan State Volleyball. But we're gonna start with Morgan State Volleyball. 1-2 MSU, 1-2 MSU, Iowa, 5-5. There we go, all right. And I wanna do a special thanks to that Morgan Volleyball family because they have been keeping me together in so many ways. Ivy and Danielle, I so appreciate both of you guys, totally. To my Morgan State family, my co-workers, some who've been there since I transferred to Morgan in 83. I don't know if Joe is here, Kim, Teresa, Arnold, you guys have been, you've been a part of my life since I've come to Morgan State in some kind of fashion. But to my other Morgan State family, my co-workers, I appreciate you. I thank you for all you do in helping me. To Ms. Wims, you always got my back, and I did not forget you administrative day. Just my mind's been somewhere else all this week, but I got you. To my second, I call her my second mom, Ms. Wilson, I love you. You're one person I know I can go in, I can vent. You always have positive things for me. You ask me to be patient with my family, with work here at Morgan, thank you. And to good friends, Gerard, Garlic, Jeff Pope, Larnette Davis, and to Veronica Edwards. And okay, to the man I met over 28 years, which means he has known me for more than half my life. So glad you lied about your age the night we met. Because I would have been a fool to have let you go because you were 2 years younger than me. I can set the record straight because I got an audience that I paid the bartender $1 to get Jeff to come here. But it's another part to that story, but we won't get into it. Because he was sweating me from across the room. The night we met at the Gatsby's, we have been together ever since, trying to come up with words that can express and tell you how much I feel about you. Thank you for loving me, even at times when I didn't like myself. Thank you for holding me and letting me vent and sometimes drag you through hell. I love you for standing by my side, even when you tell me at times I am acting like a spoiled child, but you know I am. I love you because no matter what, you always know You always know how to make me smile. I love you because I don't have to be scared. I can truly live. I love you because you love me no matter who I am. Okay. Expression on your face of love and trust sometimes makes it hard to breathe. Thank you for loving me for who I am, not just who I could be. You have never even looked down at me. Thank you for being everything I never even knew that I needed in a man. You're truly my best friend. Your love means so much to me. How can I ever thank you for all of the wonderful memories that you've given me? I'm truly grateful to have found someone as wonderful to love as you. My heart is yours now and forever. I couldn't have hoped for a better partner to share my life. You're an incredible man, and I'm so grateful to have been blessed with your love and companionship. Thank you, my darling, for the memories we shared and those we have yet to create. Thank you for giving me this party. And if I forgot someone, I apologize, but I'm so very grateful. Thank you.
I'm going to have the Panama Band. This is an outstanding group. I think you guys are going to enjoy them. So again, once again, this is all about celebration. Please help us celebrate by getting up out of your seat when the music starts and having a good time. Because really, that's a gift. All right? Thank you.
And I'm sorry. You know, the biggest thing is that if I can look around this room and I see you guys smiling and you're having fun, I'm having fun. I love to dance. And so pretty soon I'm gonna kick these shoes off so we can have some fun. So I didn't know Panama. I love this group. So.
The dance floor is up. Let's have a party going on up here, y'all. We gotta take this past two tonight.
Just as a reminder to myself.